Pujya Swamiji, Ramakrishna Mission Swamiji, I saw just saw outside. Respected professors, academic faculty members who are here, and my dear beloved friends, my beloved friends. Yesterday, I had good opportunity to be with you to speak about how Swami Vivekananda, normally whom we call as a spiritual person, how he has also done a wonderful science, and that wonderful science, how he was able to produce the type of imagination or intuitive power. If that imagination, intuition is only just imagination of no use, but it has been seen that imagination in engineering play a vital role. For that matter, the constructive imagination, the constructive intuitive power can change the whole of the environment of the people, that what we have seen in nutshell yesterday. Voice is not that what we have seen. Now, I would ask a question on behalf of you. Swamiji, yes, you have done all the spiritual practices and all the other thing, and you have showed the way for the others, but did you put into the practice of what you are telling? The complete verse of Swami Vivekananda, if you read, we have a question to Swamiji itself, whether Swamiji has done anything that in his own life he has put into the practice, that what made him the excel of what we call him. That is question one. Number one. Number two, Swamiji, you have adopted that one. Is it useful for the youth or the next generation, whether it is possible to implement that one? These two questions I try to answer in this particular session of today evening. So the title of the thing is that Human Excellence, Swami Vivekananda Way. Why do I say is that one? Because human excellence, each one has got in their own way. Because each one of us potentially divine, that what Swami Vivekananda says. If each one is potentially divine, each one has got unique way of expressing the human excellence also. But what is the human excellence as per Swami Vivekananda of what I have seen? See, he may not be, I am not representing exactly Swami Vivekananda. The way I saw Swami Vivekananda, how the human excellence has been expressed or reflected in his life and all the other things. See, for example, in any country, for that matter, particularly India, we have very many great personalities are there. Personalities in sports, personalities in the film theaters, personalities in literature, personalities in academics, personalities in scientific community, everywhere, somewhere or other, there are experts are there. There are people who reach to the peak of the thing, the excellence they achieved that one. No doubt about that one. Then you may ask a question. What it says is that the best we can be in every situation, the best we can do in every endeavor. If this is there, the best comes out of that person. So this category of the people, they are the best in that one. Then are they human excellence? I will say they are excellent people, but are they human excellent? For human excellence, is there any other factor that is missing at all? Say, for example, some of the sports personalities, stars, or somebody, and all the other thing, as with the time, yes, they rise to the peak, and suddenly over a period of time, they will fall down also. That is not the excellence, that is temporary excellence. But what is the permanent excellence? See, for example, Swami Vivekananda is there. 150th birth year, why we have to celebrate that one? After 150 years, it has to be faded away. Instead of fading away, the picking up the momentum is there for Swami Vivekananda. Why it is happening? Instead of falling down the curve is trying to pick it up. That is what is called the human excellence. That portion of the human excellence, I would try to say that one. One of the best things that I can say is that what Swami Vivekananda, he is Raja and Rishi. Raja and Rishi. Raja on one side, somebody in Western countries. Now, one person from India, he come. The way he is walking, he must be a king. He must be a king physically. Not only physically, he is a king in any subject that what you have taken. Yesterday, science we have seen, and some other places in some other thing we can see. He was a king in that particular subject and all the other thing. After being a king, not only a king, he is a rishi too. he is a rishi. What is the character of the rishi? Yes, do the excellent thing. For the sake of what? Not for my sake. For the entire society, the whole humanity, as I see as one, the rishi of detaching of the thing of the glories of what they achieve. The best personalities, they achieve the best things, but they get attached to that one. But here is Swamiji who says, yes, I do the things. What he says at the end, my voice must be there, but not my name. I leave voice without a voice, without a form, that's what he says. It is not the name. It is my ideas, they must go, they must percolate. That is the non-attachment, non-act, saying that acquisition of the power, saying that it is mine and all the other things. So the Raja and Rishi, Rajarshi, actually in management, today the one of the best management courses that are coming in IIMs and all the other things is Rajarshi as a management. This Rajarshi management is coming, stemming from the fact that Swami Vivekananda has demonstrated himself as Raja in any particular field and simultaneously a Rishi. So this is one of the specific feature of Rajarshi. When once a person becomes Rajarshi, he will become human excellence. Now the personalities of various disciplines and all the other things, I don't want to take the names of the people. Those people, they have achieved the excellence, but are they Rajarshis? No, they are attached to their own things and all. Let us forget about that one. But Swami Vivekananda, how he distinctly different from the other people is that he is a Rajarshi. Because of that Rajarshi, the human excellence has come. But how to achieve that one? That Swami Vivekananda, he himself, he says, each soul is potentially divine. The goal is to manifest that one to achieve the human excellence. For that one, what are the ways and means, he says? He says, controlling the nature, internal or external. You take whatever the path that what you want to do, but be self unselfishness and be the person who is involved into that one. When once you do that one work, either by work or worship or psychic control, whatever the thing that you do, that you will achieve the human excellence. Swamiji, yes, these are all very, just now I was talking to one couple of the youngsters in Gymkhana. When I was talking after 5 minutes, they said, sir, what are we are talking is the generalities and all the other thing. Why not we can come to the specifics, why we are like this and all the other thing. I know the youth, they are all generalities is not the thing, the specifics that are important. Here Swami Vivekananda, he has given a broad canvas for you. Do anything, then you will achieve the excellence. But in that one, he has narrowed down to some of the things. I will call them, for the simplicity sake of the thing, P, Q, R, S and T. This P, Q, R, S and T, it is just like a heart. In P, you see the ECG curve you take. There are P waves are there, Q waves are there, S waves are there, T waves are there and all. Any of the waves that are not working properly, yes, the heart is not working properly. So the human excellence also, it is not excellence in a particular domain that makes him that his heart very beautiful. It has to work in all the fields of P, Q, S, R, T, what they are. That what is the question I will talk to you. The first one is purity, patience and perseverance. Yesterday I touched upon this one, the purity, patience and perseverance. Whether this purity, patience and perseverance are required in sacred and secular. Yes, in sacred spiritual life, one has to have that purity. Without purity, no spiritual life is there. And to achieve that one, a patience is there. Daily it is a life of constant struggle and frustrations and all the other thing. And there will be failures and all the other thing. And afterwards, then comes the perseverance. In spite of the failures and all the other thing, I achieve that one. In the case of Sri Ramakrishna, if you read the life story of the thing, he has struggled. Some of the days, agonies he had and all the other thing. He had the patience, he had the perseverance. Finally, the divine vision has come for him. That is the spirituality in the. What about the scientist? The scientist, today I think of a one particular experiment. Tomorrow the result has to come. No, it cannot come. The science doesn't know with a pure, are you looking for the truth or not? It doesn't see whether it is, what is the gender, what, who is the personality behind that one and all the other thing. Science knows only the truth, nothing else. So in scientific community also, or whatever it is, on one side the spirituality, on scientific side also, yes, you need to have purity of the mind. If the mind is biased, the same curve of what you are seeing, if your mind is biased, the interpretations will be different. And you do the experiments and you fail in that one. If you don't have the patience, there will be a story of that one. A man wanted to bring up a plant, and then he has put the seeds, put some place. He waited for 5 days, plants have not come, so he dug somewhere else, and again seen nothing has come, and again like that. Actually, Sri Ramakrishna's story, digging of the well of water. So this digging of the well at few places constantly from different, no patience, because today I dig, tomorrow water has to come. But if you would have done constantly with patience, probably he would have gone 10 times into 3 feet, 30 feet he would have got the water. So the patience is one of the most important thing, even in scientific community too. And then sometimes after doing the thing, especially the PhD students and all, they know it very well, even at the fourth year or fifth year and all the other thing, what the PhD I have done, the work is adequate enough or not. In spite of the patience, there are some failures and all the other thing. So perseverance is one of the most important thing. So purity, patience, and perseverance, whether it is sacred or secular, is most important. Now, whether Swami Vivekananda has adopted in his life, that is the question mark. That first, what I started with him. See, his personality we cannot question, because the purity, impeccable personality, and patience. With a patience, he has traveled the entire India, whether there is food or not, whether somebody abused or not, whether somebody praised him or not. None of these things, they mattered for him. With patience, he has traveled all the way fearlessly, and then swam the Kanyakumari rock and saw on that one. There are failures. There are some places he was very much invited. Some places abuses were there. He never lost the temper of that patience, and then the perseverance was there. The perseverance, with that perseverance, what? In India, I am not getting the support. Let me go and get the support from the foreign countries and all the other thing. That is the perseverance. Even though in India I failed, I will go and get that one from the outside. For what? For the betterment of India. So with that one, has he got that one? Yes. Only it is because of some of the sacred personalities, the Ramakrishna Mission has come, or any other scientific organizations, they have come because of his purity, patience, and perseverance. Because of that one, today what we are seeing, the Ramakrishna Mission, which is one of the best globally. And what he has done, Atmano Mokshardham Jagat Hitayacha, for the sake of the welfare of the society, for my own salvation. How I get the salvation? For the welfare of the society, for doing all this one, the purity, the patience, and perseverance is required. That what Swami Vivekananda has demonstrated in his life. Next one, P is over. Then you may ask me, Murthy, whether you have. I said, I'll come to these things in the later part of my talk. Swami Vivekananda's thing we are talking about. Now the question, Q. What is Q? Questioning and curiosity, query. That is the most important thing in spiritual life or the scientific life, more important. If you, the day you don't question yourself, the progress is lost. What is scientific temper? Questioning is the scientific temper. So Vivekananda has got that scientific temper of questioning, and that questioning also without fear, without expectations or any other thing. Seeking for the truth, putting of the question is the fundamental thing. What he has done? He went and he asked Sri Ramakrishna, Sri Ramakrishna, have you seen God? People are saying that you have seen God and all. Have you seen God? Many of the people, when we go to the sacred people with either fear or with expectation, something we go. But fearlessly, here is the Naren who goes to Sri Ramakrishna, have you seen God? Then that man is a giant of one more of Sri Swami Vivekananda. He said, yes, I have seen. Can you show me? Yes, I will demonstrate and I will show you. And I am able to see that one, the ultimate truth, much more clearer than I am able to see you, Naren. That what he said. Is it scientific or not? He says, I have seen and I will show you the way, and I can show you the way also. Is it not scientific? Yes, the questioning is the most important. And when he was a lad, you know it very well, Naren. He was playing in a mango tree, and evening it has come. They told that man, he came and he said, hey, you children, please go away. Evening, the devils will come. Then Swami Vivekananda, he wanted to question whether it is by fear I have to accept this one, or because that man, he has said, I'll search for the truth, and I'll see whether devil is there or not. All the other children run away, but this Naren, he did not run away. Then when the old man, he came, what are you doing here? I am searching for the devil to come and see. So where is the devil? So the man who is in search of the truth, he is fearless. And without that fearlessness, with that fearlessness, what he seeks is that keep on questioning. That is the thing that what has come. Then when he has gone throughout the country, he was questioning, why my country is like this? Why my country, my fellow men have become like this? Always questioning and all the other thing. For these questionings, when they are sincere and when they are with purity of the thing, the answers, they will come. Not only Swami Vivekananda, he has seen the transcendental thing of yesterday, what we have seen, questioning in spirituality side and on the secular side also, for his questionings, he got the answers. So the second most fundamental thing for the excellence is that the questioning power. Each of the community persons sitting over here, we have to have that courage. We have to, when we lost the courage of the thing, we stop questioning of the person. The day we stop the questioning of the thing, we lost everything. Actually, to be, for that matter, wherever the knowledge gaining is there, questioning is there. A small child, 2 years, 3 years, pure, innocent, very truthful, seeking for the knowledge. What it says, hey, tell me this one, tell me that one. The questioning, keep on, humpty number of questions, and all the parents, they get fed up. Probably all your parents also would have got fed up when they are bringing up when you are 5 years old or 6 years old or with your naughty questions and all the other thing. But as we grow old, are we putting the same questions to our professors? Are we putting the same questions to the society? Are we putting the same questions to ourselves and all the other thing? The questioning capacity we are losing. When the questioning capacity we are losing, are we looking for towards the human excellence? That is the question mark that what you have to see. So the questioning is the most important thing, along with purity, patience, and perseverance. The questioning with of that temperament P, that is the second most important thing. Now, normally, we have something, believe nothing or everything because merely you are told about it, because it is traditional, or because you yourself have imagined it, or believe what the teacher spiritual tell merely out of respect for the teacher. Normally, most of the things we do, either because somebody has said that one, or because some elderly person has said that one, I don't want to question at all. Yes, that is true. But Swami Vivekananda also, he could have believed Sri Ramakrishna, but he questioned in spite of all these things. But whatever the effect, due examination and analysis. You accept of the elders, but have due examination and analysis. In science, when you are searching for the truth, when you put the question, somebody comes and says, will you accept it? You have to subject that one for the question analysis. And then after the analysis shows the results, then you please accept. Or otherwise, will you accept any of your scientific temperaments and scientific experimentations and all the other thing? No, no. So that is the thing. Then, my dear, questioning everything before you accept. Swami Vivekananda, he questioned himself. And the spiritual thing, people are afraid of talking about the spirituality of the thing. Vivekananda, what he says, daringly you say, Vivekananda constantly remind Indians that out of hopelessly intricate mythology must come concrete moral forms, and out of bewildering yogism must come the most scientific and practical psychology. What he means is that all your Vedanta, all your spirituality, subject for questioning, subject for your scientific investigations, if they are coming true, you please accept it. If they are not coming true, please throw away through the windows. What a beautiful personality. Which spiritual giant will tell such a thing, saying that please don't accept because I said to you like this and all the other thing. And he himself, the Vedanta, Vedas and all the other thing, which we venerate, which we respect, he says, throw them into the Ganges if they are not standing the test of the science. What is the test of the science? The science, it only, the questions, when the questions are answered properly, when analysis come properly, when the answers are satisfactory, then only the results will be taken. So the excellence portion of the thing, along with that P, the Q of this portion of this sincere questioning is one more thing that what he demonstrated in his life, practically practicing of that one. And then, what is this R? It is, I call it as receive, recall, and reconstruct. Receive, recall, and reconstruct. You are all fortunate IIT students. You are all the cream of the India. You know it very well, and all the other thing. But I have seen many of the youngsters, they come for the interviews. When we put a question, he says, sir, this has been dealt in first year and second year, I have forgotten, so I don't have any answer. I cannot answer for that one. Okay, let us have some question in your final fifth year or eighth semester and all. Sir, this is not completely, totally done, so I don't have the answer. For the old one, I don't have the answer. For the latest one also, I don't have the answer. Then what you can do, sir, then, sir, you ask any question other than these things. What questions we can ask in the interview? This is the type of the thing. Why this system is happening? Our educational system, is it really the correct type of the education? When you go back to your ancient system of Swami Vivekananda, he also got modern education. He also got FA, he also got the law and all the other thing. He has not denounced any of the Western type of the education, but he has never lost the Indian type of the system, what it is called, Sravana Manana Nidhijasana. Sravana Manana Nidhijasana. Sravana, listen. Are we listening in the class? I don't need to listen to the class and the professor because in the net it is there. I don't need to listen. Sravana is over. Manana, I don't need to remember. Why I should remember when the tap is there? So and so button, I press the button, the answer is coming. Why I should unnecessarily load my head with all the manana? No. You have the food. Now you take full of food. And then it is not digested. It is a stomach pain. Similarly, the knowledge that what we are accumulating, if it is not digested properly, then we land up in problems. That is the problem of what we're facing. So Swami Vivekananda, he has gone receive and recall. Receive what? The Vedantic knowledge he received from Sri Ramakrishna. And he himself, he has studied, received, and then recall. When you recall, when the necessity comes, the recall has to come. When the necessity has come, when he went abroad. When he went abroad in foreign countries, Swamiji, you come and you speak of the spirituality, but does it apply for our science? Now the question has come. Now he has to recall of whatever the knowledge. And after recalling of the, that one, what you have to do? Reconstitute with the known information for a given problem. You apply, reconstitute, and find the solution for that one. Yesterday of what we have seen is that the Vedanta principles for the science of what he has done, Vedantic principles of unity he has known. And then the question of what are the problems of Newtonian or Darwin and all the other thing. For that one, he reconstituted and reconstructed all the Vedantic knowledge to that of the modern thing. That's why he has made so many Nobel laureates to come out of his ideas and concepts and all the other thing. So they receive, recall, reconstitute. He has practically demonstrated in his life. Question yourself, please, my dear young friends. Am I doing recall, receive, recall, and reconstruct in a constructive way, not in a destructive way or any other thing? Am I doing this one constructively? This is one of the things which is excellence, that what is required, one of the component that what is required, and that is one of the things Swami Vivekananda has implemented in his life personally. Now, I'll come to the yes. What is this yes? Yes is nothing but Shraddha. Swami Vivekananda, if you read the whole literature, constantly he says two words, be fearless and have the Shraddha. Fearless he has demonstrated. Of course, at one point he tumbled when monkeys were chasing. He was afraid. But another voice has come and somebody has said, face the brute. Yes, he turned. Ferocious, he became a tiger, a lion. The monkeys ran away. The fear also gone away once for all. And if he was having a fear, probably midnight, having the crocodiles and having a depth of nearly 1 kilometer from the mainland to that of the Kanyakumari rock, anybody lad can jump into that one. If he has got a fear, fearlessly he has gone. Along with fearlessness word, abhi, abhi, of what Swami Vivekananda says, along with that one, Shraddha. Shraddha is the most important. For Shraddha, there is no equivalent word in English. I tried to find out, I could not find. Swami Vivekananda himself, he says, there is no equivalent word for Shraddha. What is that Shraddha? The commitment that once you have, And when once you have love for that one along with that one, this Shraddha comes. All of you came to the IIT Kanpur or IITs and all the other thing, unless you had Shraddha during the days of your stage of entry examinations, you would not have got that one. So you got that Shraddha already. That Shraddha for getting into the IIT. But Shraddha of becoming human excellence, whether I am having or not, is the question that what we have to see now. That is the next portion of the thing that what we have to see. So this Shraddha is the most important thing. And this Shraddha, for that one, he just simply says, take up one idea and make that idea your life. Think of it, dream of it, and all the other thing. Not so many things and all. Take only one thing. On that one, have Shraddha. On that one, you have the questioning mind. On that one, you have the purity of the approach. On that one, you have the patience. On that one, you have the perseverance of the thing. Yes, excellence will come. That's what he says. So, and then he got the famous story of Nachiketa. All of you know the story of Nachiketa? Yes? Nachiketa story. If I don't want to repeat much, but the Nachiketa story is that when father was giving away the alms, some of the gifts and all the other thing after some yajna, then this young lad, he asked question with purity. And he waited patiently, father, what he is doing. With purity of mind he has seen. And then he questioned his father, to whom you are going to give me? Innocent question. Then he said, out of for a thing he got wild, I'll give it to Emma. The death I'll give. Then he said, okay, happily, I will go. Well, out of that one, he went. And then after meeting the Emma, the story is that for 3 nights he waited because Emma went outside in search of somebody else and all the other thing. Because for that one, he said he would like to give 3 boons. And then asked this man, this young man, the young boy, he was asking questions. And he was tempted. I'll give you this one. I'll give you that one. Don't ask these questions and all. Then he says, with all these things, can I achieve my goal of excellence? No, you will not. Then I don't want any of these things. Please give me that knowledge that gives the excellence so that I live forever. So Nachiketa, he had that purity, patience, perseverance with questioning capacity and with Shraddha, Shraddha of love to know what exactly is the truth. With that Shraddha, when he approached that one, yes, he got that one. So Swami Vivekananda constantly reminds the youngsters, and he himself, he had that Shraddha. What is that Shraddha? If you have that Shraddha, what happens? Once he went to the library, and then he was taking a book reading within 5 minutes and then coming back and all. Somebody got a doubt. Actually, 3-4 incidents are there in Swamiji's life. And then, have you read it? Then he said, Swamiji, yes, I read it. Even some people, they have spent for some years and years together. They could not understand. You just go inside and then come back and see, say, then Swamiji, he said, you please open book of any page and ask that one. Practically, that man, he opened the page and he asked, Swamiji, please tell. Verbalism, he started telling. Swami Vivekananda. And then what he used to do, then he has revealed his secrets also once a while. Actually, people, you read Swami Vivekananda by Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda life by Vivekananda himself. When a sentence is there, first word, last word he used to read, in between he used to make it imagination with purity of the thought. And first page, first sentence and last sentence of the page, entire page he can read. The first page and last page of the book, the entire book he can get it. People they got ekasantagrahi, some other divine things and all the other thing. None of these things. The thing is that with a Shraddha, at that moment, for him, nothing comes into the mind except that one that is the only one that goes into his mind. So the Shraddha is one more important thing. Practically, he demonstrated in his life all throughout their life. Whatever the work that he has done, Shraddha was there. Shraddha was there. Once upon a time, some instance, I cannot stop recalling of the thing. There was a famine, and Ramakrishna Mission was there. And Ramakrishna Mission stands for serving of the humanity. And Swamiji, he got up and he said, now we have to serve these people. Some of the question has come, where from the money will come? Then he said, what for all these buildings? I'll sell away the buildings. And out of that money that comes, I'll serve the people. You see the Shraddha. Shraddha of serving the man, serving the man, because I see the divinity in each and every person. If I see the divinity in each and every person, is it just by, for the words? It is by Shraddha, it has got. So with that one, that what he is personally ready to sacrifice the thing for that having Shraddha. So that is one of the most important parameter. And then after Shraddha, Seva and service. Seva and service. You have the Shraddha, you have achieved the excellence. But after achieving the excellence, Seva and service. What is the importance of this one? The Nobel laureate Einstein, he says, I stand on the shoulders of so many people work, and then I did my work. Now what is my duty? It is my sacred duty, because I have taken the knowledge of so many people on their shoulders I am sitting. It is my duty, whatever I do, give it back to the society. You see the greatness of the thing? That is what is service. That is what is service. Swami Vivekananda, he got all the thing, and he was ready to sacrifice the thing also for the sake of the man. Man making, for that man making, the human excellence for that one, he was ready to give it away. That seva, is it there? He says in one place, passion to excel and compassion to share. So long as the millions live in hunger and ignorance, I should hold every man a traitor, having been educated at the expenses, pay not the least heed of them. The roads laid by whom? Poor fellows. The houses we live, who are constructors? The laborers. They say whatever they think that what we do in life, everything is done by the poor beggars. The moment scavengers, some once upon a time in the country, they does all the thing. When once the job is over, you fellow, touch me not. Don't touch me, you are untouchable. But for getting all the work done, yes, that poor man is required. And in Bangalore cities like Bangalore, Bombay and all the other thing, we need laborers. But the laborers should not be a neighbor for me. Why? Because I want them only for the work. But when that question of the thing, oh, my social status comes. My sacrifice will not come in that one. So the whole of the thing of what we see, people may achieve the great excellence, but that seva, the service attitude, if it is not there, the excellence is not there. If anybody who has achieved the highest thing, if they have not done the service, you see their name never lasted for a long time. And Ramakrishna Mission today, it stands not for any of the thing, because of the service. Because of the service, service is the utmost thing. So compassion is the most important thing. Passion to excel, have that passion. Yes, I want to become Nobel laureate, like Einstein, yes. But have the compassion of what I learned out of the, it is the sacrifice of so many people, I have to give back. Can I give back? How I give back? That compassion, if it is not there, then he dares to say, somebody is saying that traitor, at the expense of the, in India, every individual pays the tax. Even the poor man also pays indirectly the tax, because the country belongs to them. We exclude, take away all his benefits. We get all our education, but we don't look back again towards them. And you say, oh, I got educated on my own. I am an independent man. I got educated because my parents, they have taught me. I am an independent man. Are you independent in this world? No, you don't have. When once the job is done, you throw away just like a toilet paper. Toilet paper is nicely kept with all foldings and all the other thing before use. When once we use the toilet paper, you throw it away into the dustbin, waste bin. The poor people, the compassionate people, they are also used as toilet papers by in the hands of all the so-called advanced people. That is the problem, why the human excellence is not coming out of it. That is what Swami Vivekananda has demonstrated. Swami Vivekananda has demonstrated that one. So that is other part of the excellence. Then what is T? T is turn inside. All the time, if any problem is there, go to the computer. If anything is there, go to the computer, something else. Always go outside, 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 outside. the senses, they all go outside. Never they turn inside. When they turn inside, what will happen? As Swami Vivekananda has turned inside, yes, he turned inside. The transcendental experience of what he got of oneness, of unique experience of that one scientifically proven experience is that he turned inside. When he turned inside, the inside laboratory has brought out, and that result he tried to apply for the outside world. See, the intuitive mind, actually turning inside the other world sees nothing but you look for yourself, the solutions from within you, you pull it out. There is a saying, I was just mentioning somewhere, Saigal, very great singer, very beautiful singer, Saigal. And later on, Mukesh has also come. Your generation, you may not remember these names and all. Mukesh was singing. And afterwards, somebody asked, hey, Mukesh, what are you doing? I am singing very nicely. What way you are singing? I am trying to practicing like Saigal to sing like Saigal. Then this gentleman, he said, my dear friend, if you practice, people will tell you are singing like Saigal. They will never say Muhammad Rafi is singing. What it means is that don't imitate beyond certain point somebody. Turn inside yourself. Make yourself of your own originality. Then only the originality will come out of that one. So the turning inside, thrown as a floodlight. Under that floodlight, you take whether it is science, whether it is spirituality, whether it is some other life. Yes, that beacon of light is there. That is what is the thing that what has happened in my life.